had no relative in Dar es Salaam. I had only my wallet, 250,000 Tanzanian shillings. In Dar es Salaam, my intention was to register newspaper. So I started all the processes of registering a newspaper. At the end, when I finished the registration, all the money was gone. So I had a certificate, but no capital. That's why I argue with people when they tell me the obstacle to their achievement and success in life is capital. Capital is not important. The most important thing in life is not money first, but the idea first. So, I had an idea, but no money. I started knocking people's doors and asking for assistance and support. Some of them kicked me out, but I never gave up. I kept them going, believing in my dream. I told some other people, man, I want to start a newspaper. I was seen crazy. I was seen whatever you call me, with no money and an idea of starting a newspaper in Tanzania where there are people like Mengi, Letinia Urawa, and Generali Lumwengu. It was almost impossible to think that I could do what I do. So I knocked so many doors, so many people kicked me out. Eventually I met one guy by the name of Adam J. I talked to him, I told him about my dream. I said, man, I have a dream of a newspaper which is not in Tanzania. There are so many mainstream newspapers, but no tabloids. So it was unique. It was an idea that wasn't there. That guy was rich, and I had only an idea but no money with me. I talked to him, I asked him, can you give me a credit facility, printing my newspapers and coming pay you the day after? He said, no, go back and come in a week. A week later I went there and he said, okay, I'm gonna try. I promised to be faithful. And I was very faithful to him. That's what I started. But you know, in Dar es Salaam I slept outside. You all know Kisutu bus stand, right?
Yes.
That was my home. I used to sleep there outside because I had no money and I knew nobody now. Some of you know my story. I have told this story so many places. Today, 12 years later, my company is the most selling company in terms of newspapers in Tanzania. We have 8 newspapers. Tabloids. That's what I do. I'm proud of it. Some people don't touch my papers, it's okay. But I'm telling you, that's what I do. Today, 12 years later, from that humble beginning, I have 8 newspapers. I own 2 hotels in that, Johannesburg Hotel and Ashrams Hotel. I am as well in Marine Transport. I am a farmer as well. Some of you who have been to Bagamoyo, there's a place called Kiwangwa. I own a pineapple farm. I have 250 acres. My president is my neighbor. Our farm is a neighbor. So when he was Minister for Foreign Affairs, we used to meet there and talk. Nowadays, I can't see them. But I have 90 acres plantation of pineapples. The rest is about 18 acres not yet cultivated. That's what I do. But why am I standing here? I'm standing here not to brag about myself. I'm standing here to encourage somebody. Diaspora, you're powerful. Diaspora, you can do it. I know you're full of fear. People tell a lot of lies to you. And you have ideas that can make you billionaires, but you are waiting for money to come. Money won't come. You have to start. You have to start with whatever you have. Start with whatever you have in hand. The rest will what?
Will come.
I started with an idea. Today I have the people and as well as the money. What if I would have just decided to stay home and say I'm waiting for Mr. Renaiko to give me cash? Would I be standing here talking to you? So I'm encouraging you to ask for, please and please move ahead with your ideas. Keep in your mind one principle, very important principle, that says there are people with ideas but no money. But there are people with money, no what?
Ideas.
There has to be a link between the two. But before you link with somebody, make sure your idea is protected. Because people, groups, they can steal your what? But again, you have to take some amount of risk. Calculated what? Risks. Because if you just keep your idea in the cupboard, saying, man, if I tell somebody my idea, I'll be lost, you'll die before you know you will be there. Are we together?
Yeah.
So I wouldn't like to take much of your time. I've come here for only one thing, to encourage you. You guys have really artist ideas, I am sure. But fear, procrastinations, hesitations every day, you're waiting for the right time to come. There's nothing like right time. Just start. The moment you start, you'll see the rest of the things coming your way. Back home, nobody knows that I slept outside. Or the rich people in Dar es Salaam are my friends. I meet them, talk to them. Not only spending time with them, but learning from them every single day. That's what I do. You know what? I'd not go to a lot of schools just like you. So to me, every day I say, I don't know. So I keep learning, because to me, learning is a lifelong process. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much and God bless you.